any and every element in our lives that doesn't reflect the holiness that he has called us to. Let's briefly examine the seven churches found in Revelation to examine the characteristic of each and find which one that we as individuals may fall into. If Yahweh is indeed separating us into one of his churches in the times we are living in, may we be open and honest with ourselves and change what needs to be changed before it all starts. Please note that as we examine these churches to see just where we might stand, that this is not a time to think more highly of ourselves, but rather give sober judgment. Romans 12, verse 3. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. Mm-hmm. So now let's begin with the first church, which is Ephesus. In Revelation 2, verse 1 to 3, to the angel of the church in Ephesus write, the words of him who holds the seven stars in his right hand, who walks among the seven golden lampstands. I know your works, your toil, and your patient endurance, and how you cannot bear with those who are evil, but have tested those who call themselves apostles and are not, and found them to be false. I know you are enduring patiently and bearing up for my name's sake, and you have not grown weary. Up to this point, there is no doubt that the believers in this fellowship were at one point faithful followers of Yeshua. Ephesus means desirable. So, but I have this against you, that you have abandoned the love you had at first. Remember, therefore, from where you have fallen, repent and do the works you did at first. If not, I will come to you and remove your lampstand from its place, unless you repent. Yet, this you have, you hate the works of the Nicolaitans, which I also hate. The word Nicolaitans is broken down into two words in Greek. The first word is Nikos. It is defined as a conquest, victory, triumph, the conquered, and by implication, dominancy over the defeated. And next is Laos. It means people. And lastly, ton is the third and last word entering into the construction of the proper name Nicolaitan. The full meaning of the word Nicolaitan in its native tongue is that the leadership of the church have gained a triumphal victory or conquest over the layton, the laity, until they have been compelled to submit to the dominion of men who have become that thing which God hates.
Amen.
Could Ephesus represent people who may have been burned from these church leaders and have in turn walked away from the faith, all the while holding their disdain for any and all the church leaders that try to usurp the authority that belongs to Yeshua.
Amen.
And Yeshua concludes in Revelation 2, verse 7,
it's true.